In this Zener clipping circuit, the diode D1 is reverse biased during the positive half cycle, while D2 is forward biased, which it will act as a normal diode. Reverse bias, forward bias. Therefore, D1 will require 9.1 volt to conduct, and D2 will only need 0.7 volt to operate. Now, since D1 and D2 are in series, when the input voltage reaches to 9.1 plus 0.7 volt, then both D1 and D2 will start conducting and hold the voltage constant 9.8 volt at VO1 terminal. This will continue until the input voltage falls below this value. So let me write what's being said. At the same time, VO1 terminal is connected to D3 through the resistor R2. Therefore, D3 will be forward biased and it will need only 0.7 volt to conduct, while D4 is reverse biased, which will need 6.8 volt to be at its Zener breakdown region to turn on. Again, since D3 and D4 diodes are in series, then the voltage at the output terminal VO won't go above 0.7 plus 6.8 volt during the positive cycle. Let me write the output expression. Here are the VO1 and VO waveforms during the positive cycle. By the way, if you like what you are watching, please hit the like button and also subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet. This will really help the channel to grow and encourage me to continue creating more and better content. Now back to the video. During the negative half cycle, D1 will forward and D2 will reverse bias. This means D1 will only need minus 0.7 volt to conduct, while D2 will need minus 16 volt. Again, because these two diodes are in series, when the input voltage reaches to minus 16.7 volt, then D1 and D2 will turn on and hold the voltage constant at the VO1 terminal. So we will have this minus 16.7 volt then is applied to D3 and D4 through the resistor R2. Therefore, D3 will be reverse while D4 forward biased. With the same discussed analogy, D3 and D4 will start conducting when the voltage at the VO1 terminal reaches to minus 5.4 volt. Therefore, the output voltage at the VO terminal will be held at this minus 5.4 volt until the VO1 voltage falls below this value. So we will get here are the VO1 and VO waveforms during the positive and negative cycles. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. I will be making more videos on diodes and clipping circuits. So please subscribe and hit the notification bell if you would like to get notified when I publish those videos.